Next stop, the Blue Whale.
Our names are Mike and Heather. We're traveling the U.S. in our van Appa on a mission to visit all 50 states. Subscribe and join us as we try to figure out this whole van life thing. As always, thanks for watching. We are currently traveling down Route 66 and just crossing Oklahoma. As we did, we got a dreaded dashboard light. Now, I looked it up in the booklet and it was for tire pressure. So we pulled over and we think we found the culprit. We just found a screw in one of our tires.
We've got to pull everything out to get to the stuff to drop the spare down. Don't love to see this happen, but this is the exact reason we got the extra tire. It's gonna take us a little bit of time to switch, but it's not anything to be super concerned about.
Ooh, that's heavier than it looks.
Yep.
Okay. Is it down yet?
Oh, there we go.
Good thing we got hubcaps.
There. Oh shoot.
Yeah. Oh, it ate up some of the tread too when it went in.
The good news is it's on the top, it's not on the sidewall. You can patch stuff that's in the tread, so it shouldn't be too terrible. It's not the prettiest, but at least we've got it. I mean, it looks worse underneath, but we'll just check the tire pressure and then we should be good to go. We were back in the car. That actually didn't take that long. It was just a little bit wet because of the rain coming down, but
a lot wet.
This is definitely one of those things that we were prepared for. It was an annoyance, but it wasn't something that had the likelihood to derail our day.
There might have been a few swear words off camera.
All in all, it took us, what, maybe 30, 45 minutes total to do everything, and we're about to get back on the road going through Oklahoma. Seems to be going okay.
Welcome to Oklahoma, Mike.
Yep.
In all seriousness, we are very excited to be here in Oklahoma. We have some pretty exciting stops here today, including the Blue Whale. I don't know why, but this is one of the ones that I've been most excited to see because I think it's just like what you think of when you think of Route 66. We do have a few stops in between here and the Blue Whale, so let's get to it.
So we stopped here in Chelsea, Oklahoma, because we saw that there was a Route 66 underpass. Now, if you saw our video from Illinois, there was a filled-in underpass that existed because of how busy Route 66 was. They had to go under it in order to safely get across it. So we're gonna see if this one lets us actually go under, and if we can, we're definitely doing it. I think we can.
Really?
I mean, there's a staircase there. Oh, temporarily closed for repair.
No.
Bummer.
It's really cool to see an example of one of these that isn't filled in with dirt, and when they're not renovating it, to be able to go under it. So another thing to add to our next Route 66 bucket list.
What's kind of fun about this one too is up here at the top there's a U-Haul with some Route 66 stuff on it too, so I think they're very in theme.
This is where we were this morning.
Yep, Baxter Springs.
We're making our way to the well. We're somewhere in this area. Next stop, the Blue Whale.
We've got about 30 miles down the road on Route 66 before we get to the Blue Whale. It's something we've been looking forward to since the start.
The Blue Whale! We see it!
I was not expecting it to be right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it just like popped out.
We thought it was a few more miles down the road. Can't believe that this is real. So we are here at the Blue Whale of Catoosa. In 1972, a guy named Hugh Davis built this by hand for his family, and just because of how amazing it was, it kind of attracted attention all of its own. Now it is this classic Route 66 roadside attraction that is open and available for everyone to come and visit. On the Blue Whale, there's two slides, one on either side of its body, and then there's also a diving board that you could use in the past to jump in, and you can see that there are ladders to get out of the pond back onto the whale.
Oh, there was another. We passed the muffler man. Gotta turn around.
We stopped at Bucks on 66 on our way into Tulsa, Oklahoma.
We spotted the muffler man as we were passing, so we did a quick U-turn.
Yep, so there is a giant muffler man out front. His name is Buck Atom, A-T-O-M. This is not an original stop on Route 66. It is a new business that is in what once was a 1950s Pemco station. It's almost that new wave of Route 66 springing up here outside of Tulsa. They used the original mold for the muffler men to create this Buck Atom character. It really is a bringing back of the past into the modern era.
So he's not an original, but he's cast from the original. So it's bringing the old history with the new, and we thought that was really cool. So we got a little figurine of him to join us on the rest of our travels.
This wasn't actually something that was on our original stop to-do list, but the vintage neon lights, which are also recreated, and the muffler men made us do a U-turn and come back, but we are heading into Tulsa to go see a few sites before we continue on Route 66.
Mm-hmm. So we fell for the marketing ploy that is Route 66, the flashing lights, the fancy muffler man. So it really is like the old Route 66 all over again. Just a few minutes down the road from Space Cowboy Buck Atoms, that's like a mouthful, I can never say it, there is a couple of attractions along Route 66, one of them being the Woody Guthrie Center.
So Woody Guthrie was a famous American folk singer. His probably most famous song was This Land Is Your Land, and there are homages to Route 66 in that, kind of talking about equality amongst all people, and so just a really great message. But he was an Oklahoman who was actually forced down Route 66 due to some of the conditions that were occurring at the time.
Slowly building our sticker collection. So in our handy dandy book that we've been using, it's the best hits on Route 66. They actually have a few of lines from the song. It's, as I went walking that ribbon of a highway, I saw above me that endless skyway, and saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me.
The other really cool thing around here is just actually a block or so away from the Woody Guthrie Center is the Center of the Universe. If you walk to the center of it and speak, you get an echo back to you, but there's no walls. It's really just the physics of that space.
Echo.
That's pretty good.
Echo. Oh yeah.
It's something that kind of is unexpected when you go into the middle and talk, but I think it was a fun little roadside stop.
We got a few more to go today, so let's get back on the road.
We got time on our side, we're in a state of hope. I need you on my fire, I want you to know that every time you're away, I long for you so much I can find my way. Got everything here, at least to stay alive. And the time that we share makes it all worthwhile. Got this place on our own. Do you feel how we got
this
something
is it.
Strong?
Pop's Soda Ranch.
You can see the neon starting to come on. It looks so cool.
That's pretty neat.
Yeah, I like it.
Oh wow, it's a whole like.
Yeah, it like changes colors. Wow, look how many people are here.
Look how huge this is. I mean, I guess it's got to be big to fit 700 flavors. All right, let's go take a look. Whoa, you can see all the soda already lining the walls. No.
Thank you. You're a little late there, bud.
This is basically just a really cool soda shop. They have obviously the awning covered gas station because the original owner was also an oil magnate in Oklahoma. So gas and soda. There's over 700 different flavors of soda. They're arranged by color on the walls in here. And they even have a little diner, which is good because we're hungry.
We just got seated at Pop's Diner where we've got our bottomless fountain drink. So you do get a bottomless fountain drink if you eat here for dinner. This is unofficially known as the soda pop capital of the United States, which is really saying something because Americans do love their pop. So the fact that there's even more pop than the usual place here is really great.
We are really excited to try a lot of the flavors. For our bottomless drinks, I think we went kind of safe. I went with a Pop's root beer, Heather got a Dr. Pepper, but I think we're going to get a little bit crazy with the bottled sodas when we're done. We can pick six different ones. Let's see what we can find.
Okay, After a successful shopping haul, we have 6 new different types of pops to drink, and because we took so long in there, we now get to see it lit up. This neon soda pop bottle is 66 feet tall. Pop Soda Ranch was kind of our last big stop here in Oklahoma, and I feel like we could not have timed that better. We got to see it during the light, as well as the neon bottle, which is probably the most striking neon sign that we've seen so far on our Route 66 trip. So couldn't have been happier with the stop here. We got some food, we got some sweet drinks of all different sorts, and we got to see neon lights, which is something that I've been looking forward to the most on Route 66, is just seeing all the cool neon.
We are a little bit outside of Oklahoma City now. We're going to head through there and continue heading west to our next state along Route 66, which is going to be the Lone Star State, Texas.
So we are going to continue heading down Route 66 and drive a little bit through the night here to try to get as close as we can to Texas. Tomorrow starts the Texas leg of our Route 66 journey, so we'll see you.